What's up guys, Hong Nguyen here for OG Fitness. Welcome to the channel. If you're new, consider subscribing. Here we're all about a smarter and more sustainable approach to fitness and martial arts for older guys. Myself, I'm 41 years old, brown belt in judo, did BJJ for 6 years, and essentially a lifelong martial artist. So let's dive in. I got this question from one of the subscribers asking me, should he train both sides at the same time? He was asking for judo, but let's talk about that, even for BJJ, because those are the two sports that I've been involved in heavily in the last 10 years, right, of my life. So let's start with judo. In my opinion, the short answer is no. You should not try to train both sides at the same time. That being said, of course, we'll get into like the exceptions. But generally speaking, if you're starting off in judo, you want to stick to your dominant side because it's hard enough as it is to actually master one side. And now you're gonna try and, so if you try to do both, you're gonna confuse the hell out of yourself and it's gonna take you so much more time to progress. Another little tip that my coach recently gave me is that, well, most of the time when you're fighting in a judo competition or in a randori at your club, what happens is that you get uncomfortable because you know you're in a position where you don't have your dominance. You're on your dominant side, but it's not dominant enough, and it's not moving, it's not going anywhere, and you know, so then you switch. And when you switch, that's when you get prone. And it happens all the time in randori and in competition. So if you're a beginner, do not try to train two sides at the same time. Just focus on that one side. It's hard enough because in judo, there's a lot of things that go into it, right? You're standing up, it's more dynamic. There's balance that's involved. There's coordination, there's timing, you know, your hands and your feet. So, I mean, it's a lot of things to put together, right? So that's why you should really just focus on one side. Once you get more advanced, my opinion is when you get to maybe brown, black belt, okay? And everybody's different, but you know, just for the sake of argument, in my opinion, brown, you're starting to be advanced. Once you get more advanced, that's when, in my opinion, not that you should start training the other side, but you should definitely start practicing it a little bit and then have your answers to surprise your opponent. It's good to have at least, you know, maybe one or two, three techniques that you could throw on the opposite side, the less dominant side, right? That way, sometimes if you can't get anything in, and of course you gotta practice it a lot, at least you have something on the other side that you could surprise your opponent with. So that's a good thing. By the way, I'm without my shirt because I've been filming, this is the second video I'm filming today, and it gets really hot in this room. I didn't feel like wearing a t-shirt, so I'm just filming this one like this, right? And it's not to show off or anything. I'm showing you guys how I look at 41. I'm a trainer also, so anyways, we'll talk about that later. Okay, BJJ, it's the same thing. I believe that no, you should not train both sides at the same time. Focus on one side. When you get advanced enough, that's when you know you can start going on the other side. Now, me personally in BJJ, I found that by focusing on one side and really understanding the technique and how to do things well, and this goes for judo too, after that, it's easy for me to replicate it on the other side. It's even easier in BJJ because you're essentially on the ground, right? So there's not that element of, it's less dynamic, right? You don't have balance to worry about, you know, there's less coordination involved, you know, there's more room for mistake. So that's what I would do in BJJ. So I would focus more on one side, master that, and then after that, learn a couple of, you know, things on the other side where I can do well. Another approach that I like a lot is that you always find a way to get back to your dominant side. If ever you're forced into a position where you're on your least dominant side, right? Find a way to force the position, right? Get good at forcing that person, your opponent, back into your more dominant side, right? So in judo, it would mean like fighting for your grips so that you get the right side that you want, right? So you're in the position that you're comfortable with. That's my suggestion for judo and BJJ. I believe training one side at a time, getting really good at that side. When you're more advanced, then you can start dabbling, have a couple of techniques on the less dominant side, and then always have that ability to bring it to your to your dominant side. That's it for this video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Let me know what you think. How have you guys approached it? Do you guys agree, disagree? Let me know down below in the comments. In the description, there's the links to all my contact information, my social media contact info, all of that. If you're interested, guys, in working with me for coaching or whatnot, you know, to help you guys get back into fighting shape, you know, they're like the links down below. Click on that. There's a form you fill out, and I'll reach out to you. I'll see you guys in the next one. I don't want to slap my chest.
Actually,
peace.